In a press statement released by the Ministry of Health yesterday, the ministry announced an alternative solution, urging interns who are capable of covering their living expenses to apply online for internships, allowing them to be assigned to their preferred hospitals and commence their training. Opposition MPs have today expressed their rejection of the proposal by the Ministry of Health to only deploy medical interns who are in position to pay for their deployment, contrary to the current practice where government paid all medical interns. The call was led by the Shadow Minister of Health, Dr. Timothy Batua, while addressing journalists at Parliament.
The Ministry of Health decision to deploy some pre-medical interns at their own expense is outrageous, as the ministry can only change the terms of pre-medical interns deployment by amending the various laws as cited above. Dr. Diana Atwine has no powers to unilaterally change the terms and manner of deployment of pre-medical interns.
Dr. Diana yesterday said that those people who can pay for themselves can register and go and pay for internship while other people remain at home. I find this unfortunate. I find this a lame excuse. I find this unconstitutional. How do you say that you are offering a public good and, for example, and you say those people who can pay school fees and you can go to private schools, you go and start?
Legislators argued that the Ministry of Health has no powers to alter terms and conditions of deployment of pre-interns, contrary to the laws in Uganda, citing the Medical and Dental Practitioners Act, Pharmacy and Drugs Act, Nurses and Midwives Act, which all dictate that internship is mandatory and necessary for a license to practice medicine in Uganda.
Guidance is discriminatory and a blatant violation of Article 21 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda. I would like to state that Ministry of Health has no powers to alter terms and conditions of the deployment of pre-interns contrary to the laws of Uganda.
They warned that if the practice is upheld, the current pre-medical interns are likely to sue government over attempts to change their terms of deployment, and there is need to relieve taxpayers of this avoidable litigation cost through compensation of the pre-medical interns.
The actions and behavior of the Ministry of Health exposes the taxpayers of Uganda to avoidable litigation that may see us spending a lot of money to compensate for these pre-medical interns.
They scoffed at the latest policy shift to front teaching of sciences in schools, yet the government has failed to pay internships of doctors, pharmacists and nurses they produce.
Now, just 1 year after the science teachers have been enhanced, you produce doctors, you produce nurses, you produce pharmacists, and they say that you don't have money.
In April 2023, Minister Acheng revealed that there are no funds for the payment of allowances of medical interns and senior house staff in the 2023-2024 financial year, following the reduction of budget of the Minister of Health by over 75.417 billion shillings. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.